Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another average value of the function problem, and the function that we're given in this case is g of x equals cosine of x, and we're asked to find the average value of that function over the range 0 to pi over 2. So the formula that we're going to be using to do this is the following, and the first thing that we do when we use this formula, this is the formula we always use when we're looking to find the average value of the function over a given range. The first thing that we're going to do with it is plug in values for both a and b. So we're given a range from a to b. In other words, we're going to be plugging in 0 for a and pi over 2 for b. And we do that both in the fraction out front of the integral and as our limits of integration here. So we plug those two in, and that sets up our integral for us. Then what we do is simplify the fraction and integrate. So when we simplify the fraction out in front here, pi over 2 minus 0, of course, is pi over 2. Whenever you have 1 divided by a fraction, when you simplify it, the result will be the inverse of that fraction. So instead of 1 divided by pi over 2, we end up with 2 over pi. So we have 2 over pi, and that's out in front as our fraction. The integral of cosine of x is sine of x. So when we take the integral here, we get sine of x, and then, of course, we're going to be evaluating on the range 0 to pi over 2. So that's how we simplify and integrate. And then when we evaluate on this range, first we plug in pi over 2, and then we subtract and plug in 0 for x. So if you have trouble with definite integrals, I have that section of videos on my website. You can check that out, but you always plug in the top number first, and then subtract, and then plug in the bottom number. So we end up with sine of pi over 2 minus sine of 0. Now, in order to evaluate sine of pi over 2 and sine of 0, we need to use our unit circle here. So let's first look at sine of pi over 2. The way that we use the unit circle to evaluate sine of pi over 2 and sine of 0 for that matter, we're looking for the place where the angle is equal to pi over 2. So what we do is we go over here to our unit circle and we look along the circle until we find the place where the angle is equal to pi over 2, and we can see that it's right here. And that's at the point, I don't have it marked here on the circle, but that's at the point 0, 1, where x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. So because we're looking for sine of this angle, sine of pi over 2, we look at the y-coordinate at this point. And the y-coordinate here is positive 1. So, so sine of pi over 2, heading back over here to our equation, sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1. So let's go ahead and start writing that in. Sine of 0, if we head back over here to the unit circle, again, we're looking for the place where the angle is equal to 0. So we look and we see it's right here along the x-axis. The angle is equal to 0. And because we're looking for sine of that angle, we're looking at the y-coordinate. Again, when using the unit circle, if you're looking for cosine, you check out the x-coordinate. And if you're looking for sine, you look at the y-coordinate. So sine of 0, you can see here the y-coordinate is 0, so sine of 0 is going to simplify to 0. So heading back over here to the function, you see we've written in 0 here. So obviously you can see this is going to be 2 over pi times 1, which means that our final answer ends up being 2 over pi. So 2 over pi is the average value of the cosine function over the range 0 to pi over 2. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!